everyone. Welcome back to Snapfield's Grand Theft Auto. No. Okay, you know what? Get down there. Grand Theft Auto San Andreas narrative walkthrough with the new mission strand from OG Loke, unfortunately. But hey, he has a few good missions. They're kind of fun. Anyway, starting with his first mission of Life's a Beach that is only available between the times of 2200 and...
Looking real technical,
600?
Gangster. Come on. You ain't run off again yet?
No, gangster. I'm here for good.
Yeah? Well, fuck this gig, man. I'm putting together a listening party for my album. But first, I need a sound system.
Hey, I'm down as long as I don't have to go to the port.
What you talking about, fool? Guaranteed I start playing, everybody will come through.
Being real OG, I really ain't into rap no more. I'm more into that hardcore gangster shit.
Well, that's me, homie. That's me, OG Loke, baby.
Yeah, for sure. But I only like them if they rhyme real well. You know, well, anyway, what you want me to steal?
That's what I'm talking about. Love for your homies. Now check it. I caught me a real fly sound system cruising through the drive-thru. I think they headed down to the beach for a beach party. Now check this out. I'll roll with you, and on the way, I can get a couple of freestyles. It's OG Loke in the place. You don't want to stop me with a gun in your face.
Yeah, OG, man. Look, shut the fuck up. Maybe I need to do this on my own. I believe in you. Gangster for life, homie. For life.
Yeah, for life, homie.
Yeah, so we're going to have to deal with that for a few more videos. Anyway, so we're going to start by driving down to Santa Maria Beach and onto the actual sand, to the beach party. But of course, they took my motorcycle, so I'm going to actually just go ahead and take their car. There we go. And continue on down. So, I guess while I go down there, I am trying a few, or a couple different things with the rendering for my videos, because, you know, the last one did get pretty bad, as far as the pixelation goes with my videos. I don't know why it does that, but it was doing that, so I'm trying something different, and, all my videos will also now be in 1080, 60 frames a second, or it'll go up to that anyway. Yep, go to the DJ at the back of the van thing. anyway, so the only thing though is that it does take a lot longer to process because of the 1080. But hopefully, being slower,
hey, what's poppin'?
It'll catch everything. Anyway, press left on the D-pad to reply positively. And you're gonna do this twice.
Well, hey, let's dance, sugar.
And again, second.
Yeah, for sure.
And this time, we're gonna be starting with a dancing minigame. Much like the Lowrider challenge we did earlier. This time, however, instead of arrows, you'll use the four buttons on the right side of your controller, so for the Xbox, Y, X, B, A, and you have to get 2,500 points or greater, which I think before in the other older versions, it was 4,000 points, like PS2 version, Xbox One version, or not one, but original Xbox version,
you must have taken less.
Anyway, about the same concept as the Lowrider challenge, the buttons will come across the screen. But I guess for the remastered version, they let it happen a little easier by showing what is coming up in the center, depending on where your focus is at. My focus, I do a little bit before the center, just so I can kind of prepare a little better. But yes, as it goes further on, they do get a little bit more complicated. But your score, as you see, is in the top left of the screen. And of course, the more center the icons are, and the better time your button presses are, the higher score you will get. So I will go ahead and let this finish out, and yeah, we will.
Those were some new moves.
Go on after this.
How did he do that? Not bad, not bad. That's the bomb. You're getting the hang of this, honey.
Rock and roll! Best dancer I've seen in here.
You dance great! Well, you don't totally suck. Nice moves, baby. Okay, you're doing good. Nice move. You got some moves, wanna come and chat?
And left on the D-pad again.
Sound nice.
Alright, they could have given them better moves for the remastered version. That was embarrassing. Completely embarrassing. Anyway, get in the van, driver's side, and, well, we're going to be stealing sound. So, take off. Yep, they will be shooting at you, and it's possible that they'll be chasing after you as well, but you'll be, hopefully, long gone before they can catch up to you. If not, then just keep on driving. Don't worry about trying to take them out, because you need to make it to the destination. With the van, of course, still intact. If it blows up, you fail. If you die, you fail. Blah, 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 blah. The usual. The obvious. But the garage is in... Where was it? The Commerce neighborhood. And it is located under that pretzel intersection, as I like to call it. So, yep, just zigzag, make your way there as quickly as possible, and into the red marker where the garage will be to finish the mission. There you go, and respect. Gain some respect. Yeah, whatever. Hey, OG Loki's a hygiene technician, so of course he's not making too much money to pay you for that. Hey, you know, love for the homies. Anyway, so after that, we should be 16.58% towards 100% completion. That is it for this video, everyone. Hope you all enjoyed. I love you all. Peace out. Goodbye. Alright, so as you can see, there are 6 boxes that you need to collect for the main mission part, and it's just picking up the box like you saw me.
This is going to be an interactive let's play. If there's a decision to make, you will get to make it.